Hi guys, my name is Mirko and I'm your Italian tutor, and today we are going to be inspired by the most important masterpiece of the Italian literature. We are going to talk about I Promessi Sposi, or in English, Betrothed. I hope that I pronounced it several times with the tutorial, but you're going to see it here, but that is the meaning. So this time, because it is a novel, I'm not going to extract text because it can be quite hard to understand because it's in old Italian. However, I'm going to tell you the story behind it and why this opera is so important. I Promessi Sposi is a novel written by Alessandro Manzoni, and they were published in 1840. I'm doing this because this is an important element. So we need to understand that the Italian unification was in 1861. So before that, there were different states, and each state has its own language. In Tuscany, there was this variation called Fiorentino, which basically Italian comes from. Alessandro Manzoni understood that to have a unification, Italy needs also a common language, and many writers come from Tuscany. For this reason, Fiorentino was basically a point of reference for all the other writers, for example from Veneto, from Lombardy, and there is a famous statement for Alessandro Manzoni, which was, "I'm going to Florence to rinse my clothes in the Arno," which is the river that passed through Florence. Because obviously when he started writing his opera, I Promessi Sposi, there were many Lombardism and Francisism. So maybe only people from that area couldn't understand it, right?
Scrivi e provi a parlare in un bar per quel che puoi, per cercare di tenere viva quella lingua qui, perché l'unica maniera per tenere viva una lingua è...
So he decided to go to Florence basically to adjust his language, to make it a little bit more understandable to the middle class. Then, this novel is considered an historical novel. What does it mean? It means that maybe the characters are fictional, but the historical facts really happen. If you have the opportunity to read this book, you are going basically to read also a piece of history that happened in that area. For example, the plague of 1630, the dominion of the Spanish ruler, the contention of Mantua, because there were no heirs, so there was Spain, France, the Holy Roman Empire. Another coolest thing about this book is that, apart from the storylines, that you're going to love it because it's a love story, Alessandro Manzoni focused some chapters on some characters to introduce them to you and give a little bit more a background. And you're going to find out that at the end, there are many themes like politics, corruptions, crime, affair, love, history. So let's find out more about the story in the Promessi Sposi. So the main characters are Renzo and Lucia, who they basically should get married in Lecco. However, Don Rodrigo, who is the local baron, doesn't want that this wedding happens. And he sent two thugs, or bravi, to inform Don Abbondio, the priest that should celebrate the wedding.
Signoria ha intenzione di maritare domani Renzo Tramaglino e Lucia Mondella?
Cioè, signori miei, loro sono uomini di mondo e sanno benissimo come vanno queste faccende. Il povero curato non c'entra. Fanno i loro pasticci tra di loro e poi vengono da noi. Noi siamo i servitori del comune.
Orbene, questo matrimonio non sarà fare, né domani né mai.
Ma signori miei, se la cosa dipendesse da me...
Ah, queste son ciarle. Il matrimonio non si farà. O chi lo farà non se ne pentirà perché non ne avrà il tempo.
Don Abbondio is quite scared, and basically when he goes back to the church, he confesses what happened to his help, or Perpetua. On the wedding's day, Don Abbondio try to make excuses, like the wedding has to be postponed because he doesn't want to get in trouble. But Perpetua, because likes to talk, revealed to Renzo and Lucia the secrets. So they don't know what to do, and Lucia's mother, Agnese, suggested to contact the local lawyer, la zecca Garbugli. But la zecca Garbugli is the classical lawyer that is basically corrupted, or maybe has some dodgy business with someone.
Mi scusi, signor dottore, ma lei non me ne ha dato nemmeno il tempo. Ma voglio raccontarle tutto quanto dal principio.
Ma puoi iniziare pure da capo.
Quel prepotente di Don Rodrigo.
Don Rodrigo! Don Rodrigo? Ma cosa venite a rompermi la testa? Le prime certi discorsi fateli fra voi ragazzotti, umili da fare con della gente da bene che sa che cosa valgono le parole. Andiamo fuori, andiamo,
ma
via!
Io le giuro...
Ma non mi interessa niente il vostro impuramento. Via!
Ascolti, io... Via,
fuori! So Lucia is quite desperate and went to her confessor, Fra Cristoforo, to find peace. And Fra Cristoforo wants to help her and decided to go to Don Rodrigo to make him reason. But Don Rodrigo doesn't care and doesn't want to reason with anyone. He doesn't want that this wedding happens. Full stop. So Agnese decided to do a secret wedding, because at the end you need just two witnesses and newlywed needs just to pronounce the declarations. That's it. But it didn't work, unfortunately.
Com'è sospettoso il mondo. Nessuno si fida. Ecco, venite.
Bene, allora.
E date qua,
signor curato. 25 pezzi nuovi.
E eccola collana.
Grazie.
Oh. Signor curato, in presenza di questi testimoni, questa è mia moglie.
Questo è mio ma...
Tradimento! Aiuto!
Andiamo,
perpetua, perpetua! Tradimento!
Fortunately, so they decided to move from Lecco, because Don Rodrigo was constantly going after them. So Lucia and her mother went to Monza in a monastery under the protection of Gertrude. And here it's interesting because there are some chapters dedicated to the history of the nun. Renzo decided to go to Milan. So when Renzo arrived to Milan, was basically involved in these bakery strikes and was also scapegoated and arrested, but the crowd did help him to escape. He moved to Bergamo, he changed his name, and he went to live with his cousin. But Don Rodrigo is still chasing Lucia, and now he wants to kidnap her. But he knows that Lucia is under the protection of Gertrude, so he needs someone more powerful than him, and he contacts the unnamed. So here it sounds like a little bit Harry Potter. So the unnamed, or the person that mustn't be named, is a quite powerful and evil character, and thanks to him, Lucia was convinced to leave the monastery to run some errands, and there was kidnapped and conducted to the unnamed castle and locked in. And here there is a moment where Lucia wants to be free and made this vow to God and said, if you free me, I will basically stay virgin and I will not get married with Renzo. On the other side, the unnamed start having some revelations and he started feeling bad for what he did, and he went to a priest to basically ask redemption. And he also decided to free Lucia and give her his protection. But then Lucia now is basically the subject of a diplomatic conflict between Milan and Bergamo. At the end, Lucia moved to Milan under the protection of Donna Prisede. So in Milan, the situation is not very good because there were the war, a lot of casualties, famine, people they don't have money to live or to eat, and plus there is also the plague. Here we need to understand some important terminology. Lazzaretto, so lazzaretto is basically a quarantine station where basically the sick people were confined, and most of them unfortunately died, only a few recovered. For example, Renzo got sick, but then he recovered. Then we have the Monatti. Monatti were people that were going around the city with this wagon and collecting the dead body. Then there are the Untori, who were basically people accused to spread this virus. And they were spreading with ointment on the door knob or with powder on the clothes. There were real trial where people basically were put to death because they were accused to be these Untori. So Renzo, we said he got sick, but then he recovered and he went back to Lecco. When he arrived in Lecco, he found out the city that basically was destroyed. and Donna Bondio informed him that Lucia is in Milan, so he decided to go back to Milan. When he was in Milan, he was basically looking through these wagons that were passing through the city to see if she could find Lucia. But then she found out that Lucia was basically helping in the lazzaretto. And in the lazzaretto there was Fra Cristoforo, who was sick, and Don Rodrigo. Lucia, when Lorenzo said, "Unfortunately, I cannot get married with you because I made a vow to God and I cannot break it anymore." But Lorenzo didn't want to give up and ask help to Fra Cristoforo. And Fra Cristoforo basically broke the vow because he said that was made under specific and special circumstances. Don Rodrigo died and also Fra Cristoforo. Lucia and Renzo went back to Lecco and they got married. So there is an happy ending. So what do you think about this story? I really actually love it. I couldn't understand when I was younger, because you have to read this book when you are in high school and analyze every single passage. So if you like the video, remember to give it a thumbs up. If you have any question, please put in the comment section below or email me to youritaliantutor01@gmail.com. In the next video, we are going to talk about La Cenerentola. And I see you in the next class. Bye for now!